Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you for joining here. Amen. At Light of the World Church. Amen. A church where, amen, everybody is somebody. Glory be to God, and Christ is all. We praise God for his goodness, amen, and his mercy, how he has allowed us, amen, to gather once again, amen, gather together, you in your homes, and I'm here, amen, gather together, amen, hallelujah, with the word of God, amen. The word of God is going to help us to stand, is going to take the word of God, amen, to keep us, and it's going to take the word of God, amen, to keep carrying us forth, amen, by the grace of God. So again, we thank you for joining us tonight. Amen. I am Pastor Tim Brown. Amen. We honor our overseer tonight. We honor our wife on tonight. Glory to be to God. First Lady Brown, we honor our hallelujah elect Lady Jones. Amen. We also honor our assistant pastor on tonight. Our woman supervisor, to our deacons, to our mothers, amen, to our saints, and to our friends, amen. We bless the name of the Lord, for this is the day, amen, that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and continuously be glad in it. Hallelujah. The songwriter said, I will bless the Lord, amen, at all times, for he is good. Hallelujah. So the Bible tells us, oh man, hallelujah. Oh, taste and see that the Lord, he is good, for his mercy, amen, endureth forever. And so we bless the Lord on tonight. Amen. We bless the Lord on tonight for all his grace and his mercy and what he has done for us and what he's going to do right quickly. Hallelujah, coming up on the screen as you join us in tonight. Hallelujah, we want you to plant a seed, amen, as you join us on this broadcast tonight, amen, and ways you can give tonight, glory be to God, ways you can give tonight is by Cash App, amen, $Light, L-I-G-H-T, amen, 4701. You can give tonight, $Light, L-I-G-H-T, 4701. You can give, amen, by PayPal, www.paypal.me/LOTWC, amen, church. Again, that's www.paypal.me/LOTWC, church. You can also give, amen, our online giving, amen, tithe.ly, that's tithe.ly, amen. You can go to that website and you can also give, amen, to Light of the World. And maybe you don't have the technology, amen, you can also mail in your seed offering tonight, amen. Our physical address is Light of the World Church, 4701 North 15th Street, Tampa, Florida. Again, that's 4701 North 15th Street, Tampa, Florida. And also, you can give, amen, mail to our P.O. Box. Our P.O. Box is 75782 Tampa, Florida, 33675. That's P.O. Box 75782. Tampa, Florida, 33675. Amen. So those are our ways of giving on tonight. We bless the Lord again for you joining us. Amen. To this broadcast on tonight. We're going to say a word of prayer right before we go into the word of God. Amen. Father, in the precious name of Jesus, God, we just want to say thank you on tonight. We just want to say, God, that we love you. We praise you, God, for what you've done in our life. We praise you, God, for how you have continuously blessed us, God, how you have continuously had your way in our life. God, We praise you, God, even for this day, for we understand that thou art Alpha and Omega, amen, the beginning and the ending. And God, we put our trust in you tonight, that God, you will continue to bless us, that you will continue, God, to let our cup, God, overflow tonight. God, let your wisdom and knowledge, amen, sit down, God, with us tonight. And God, take us through the avenues of your word. Open up, God, the mysteries of your word tonight and bless your people. God, let your people, amen, God, be established, God, in your word. For Father, we will give your name the praise. We will give your name the glory. And we will give your name the honor. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on and clap those hands wherever you are. Amen. Hallelujah. God is going to bless us on tonight. He's going to bless us. Amen. In his word tonight. Tonight. He's going to bless us in his word. Hallelujah. And so we continuously, amen, in our Bible study series. Amen. From defeat, amen, to winning. And on tonight, we're going to be dealing with, we're going into session five, we're going into masters, amen, of the universe. Masters, amen, of the universe. And I want you to get your Bibles, and I want you to get your tablets, I want you to get your phones, amen, and join me in the Word of God as we go to Matthew, the 6th chapter and the 24th verse. Matthew, the 6th chapter and the 24th verse. Amen. Masters, hallelujah, of the universe. So, first we want to look at the definition, amen, of universe. Amen. We want to look at the definition, amen, of universe. And so, we picked out the definition here, amen, and I believe it's, amen, the second definition is dealing with, amen, a particular sphere of activity, interest, or experience, all right? Then providence, amen, world, sphere, preserve, domain, circle, all right? And so that's the universe that we're dealing with tonight. We're dealing with your universe, your world, your domain, amen, your circle, hallelujah, your interest or experience on tonight. And so that's what we're talking about when we're talking about masters of the universe. Now, notice our Bible series is from defeat, amen, moving from defeat, amen, to winning. And so if you're going to win in this season, you have to control, amen, your domain. You have to control your circle. You have to control your providence. You have to control your world, all right? And so either you're going to be masters of your universe, or your universe is going to be the master of you, all right? Now, let's go into the Word of God, and let's see where the Word of God takes us. We're going to Matthew, the 6th chapter, and the 24th verse. All right, it says, no man can serve two masters. No man can serve, amen, two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve God and mammon too. All right, now let's look at God's Word translation, same chapter, same verse of Matthew's, amen. It simply says, to break it down a little simpler, it simply says, no man can serve two masters. Either he will hate the first master and love the second master, or he will be devoted, amen, to the first master and despise the second master. Then it says, you cannot serve God and wealth. You cannot serve God, amen, and wealth. All right, now let's look at this. The original Greek of this verse says that we cannot serve God and mammon, hallelujah, in the Amrit world, meaning money and possessions. Jesus personalizes mammon here, revealing its demonic power to hold us in slavery. Money is supposed to be a tool where we use for good. In fact, it is often becomes like, amen, a demon that possesses and controls us. For this reason, Jesus is clear that we cannot serve both God and mammon. Neither will share our alliance. Both want us to fulfill attention and loyalty. How tempting is it for us to try to prove Jesus wrong about God and mammon? We want to serve God, yet if we were honest to ourselves, most of us in the Western culture also are servants to mammon, meaning servants to wealth. When I buy something I don't need so that I look good to others, I'm serving mammon. When I neglect to give away generously what God has entrusted to me so I can have more luxurious items for myself, then I am serving mammon. When I spend more time, watch this, when I spend more time worrying about money than I do seeking the kingdom of God, mammon demonstrates its grip on my heart. How can we be free? How can we free ourselves to mammon so that we might serve God wholeheartedly? When we begin to buy honestly, admitting to ourselves for mammon, we confess our mixed loyalties to God, seeking his forgiveness and cleanliness. We find fellow disciples who can keep us restructure our values and practices. All right? So, what are we talking about tonight? We have to be very careful, saints of God. This is one of the tools, amen, that the enemy uses, amen, to distract us. Now, it is not to say that you cannot have wealth. It is not to say that you cannot have, amen, a luxurious car, or you cannot have a nice home, or you cannot wear nice clothes and have jewelry. But when we allow these things to become God in our lives, where we have no time for God, then we are serving two masters. All right? You cannot serve two masters, as the Bible says. And so now we're stuck, amen, in the area of defeat. Why? Because God cannot move for us. God cannot bless us when we have a master in front of him. The word of God tells us also, amen, to have no other God before him. So we get in trouble, saints of God, when we make the home our God. We get in trouble when we make the car our God. Why? Because we're spending so much time trying to make the payment on the car, working hours and hours and upon hours, working overtime, amen, as the song says, to keep up with the Joneses, amen. We're working so much time, amen, and we're spending so much time, amen, trying to gain wealth of this world that we're losing the wealth of our soul, all right? And so, in essence, we are trying to serve two masters, where you begin, hallelujah, when you used to get up, amen, at 5 a.m. and worship your God in worship and worship God before you go to work. Now you're doing the overtime that you have to be at work at 5 o'clock, and now it cuts time off with God. There should be no instance, amen, in our life where God is second. There should be no instance in our life where we're serving material things more than we're serving God. All right? We have to be very careful, people of God. We have to be very, 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 very careful, amen, that we do not, listen to me very careful, amen, that we do not, hallelujah, put things in front of God. We cannot do that, people of God. We cannot put things, hallelujah, in front of God. This is what we cannot afford, amen, to do. This is what we cannot afford to do. And so tonight, this is what we're talking about. We cannot allow the enemy, when we put things in front of God, it moves us into being defeated. And sometimes we're so wrapped up and we're so tied up that we don't realize, amen, that we're stuck in this rut. And if the enemy can get us stuck in this rut, it's going to take the eyes of God, it's going to take the hands of God, amen, to open our eyes, amen, that we are not putting God first. It's a dangerous thing. I'll repeat over and over again on tonight. It's a dangerous thing when we don't put God first in our lives. We cannot serve two masters. And so, either, hallelujah, either we're going to get our priorities. That's one of the things, people of God, we have to do as people of God. We have to set our priorities. God should be head of our life. God should be head of our walk. God should be head of our talk. He simply tells us in Proverbs, in all your ways, acknowledge him, and he will direct our path. 9 times out of 10, God is not directing our path if we get into trouble because we didn't simply acknowledge him. We didn't simply go to him before we made decisions. We didn't simply go to him before we started our day, and he would have directed our path, and we wouldn't have got in so much trouble. We wouldn't have got in so much distress, all right? And so now it's coming to the point that we have to, amen, set our priorities in our life. And that simply is setting God as the head, amen, of our life. Why? Because if he's the head of our life, he won't lead us wrong. Amen. He won't lead us. The Bible said he will lead, amen, and he will guide us, amen, into all truth. And so tonight, people of God, we're going to become winners. Why? Because we're going to set our priorities. You ought to type on the screen, on tonight, I'm going to set, amen, my priorities. I'm going to put God first so I can win and so I can be blessed. Now, it's either or. Either we're going to walk with God or we're going to follow our flesh. We cannot. The Bible says in Revelation, he says, I wish that ye would be hot or cold, but you are neither, and you are lukewarm, and I will spill you out of my mouth. I don't know about you, but I like my food hot. I like to eat my food hot. I cannot stand, amen, lukewarm food. Even when I'm drinking tea, I like the tea to be hot. I cannot stand, amen, lukewarm tea. So what is God is actually saying in this scripture? He says, I wish, amen, that you were hot or cold. Now, let's look at that part of the scripture. He's saying, in other words, I wish, amen, that you were hot or you were cold. If you were hot, I can deal with you and I can bless you and I can get glory out of your life, and I will get the glory, and men will marvelous in my works, right? So that's when you're hot. But when you are cold, God says, I wish you were hot or cold. So if you're cold, God can get you hot. In other words, if you have no God in your life, he can deal with you better, amen, and get you saved, get you set free, and get you delivered. So that's the hot and that's the cold. Now the scripture says, but ye are lukewarm, meaning you serve me today, but tomorrow you don't serve me. You believe in me today, but the next day you reach something a little bit harder and you don't believe in me. You trust me today as your deliverer, but tomorrow you don't know if you're coming or you're going. So God says, I can't deal with that. And so he says, I wish that you're hot. I wish that you're cold. But lukewarm, I will spew you out of my mouth. And so tonight, we want to become winners. Amen. We want to be hot. We want the Spirit of God, amen, flowing in our lives and blessing our soul so that we can bless somebody else. Amen. And so that's the winning we're talking about. So either we're going to serve God or we're going to leave him alone. And so one time, amen, my overseer preached a message, love me or leave me alone. And so nobody wants someone to half love them, whether it's your husband or whether it's your wife tonight, whether it's your fiance, whether it's your children. Nobody wants them to half love them. You have to love me all the way or leave me alone. And that's the same way God wants us to be. That's the same way he desires. His characteristics is love him, amen, or leave him alone. And so now we have to make up in our minds, amen, that either we're going to love God and leave the world alone. We cannot serve two masters. To be master of your universe, amen, to be master of your domain, you're either going to have to let God lead and guide you, amen, into all truth, loving him, serving him, and he's over your life, or you're going to let the devil be over your life. Now, look at this. The devil will play tricks, and he will give you wealth for a moment, but the wealth of God, hallelujah, is everlasting. So what the devil gives you is temporary. It looks green, but under it's brown, and it destroys. But the word of God simply tells us the blessings of the Lord addeth rich, amen, and maketh no sorrow. So what we're talking about tonight, it's got to be either or it's got to be or. Either you're going to love and serve God or you're going to simply leave him alone. And tonight, we're hoping, and our prayer is that you make the decision, amen, to totally give your life to God. Now, before the pandemic, you may have went to church, amen, every other Sunday. You may have just went to church on Easter. You may have just went to church, amen, on Thanksgiving, or you might have just went to church every New Year's, amen. But now is the time that you have to make up in your mind that I'm going to serve God with all my heart, with all my mind, with all my strength. I'm not sitting here telling you that there's not going to be trials. I'm not sitting here telling you there's not going to be tribulation. But the Bible tells us greater is he that is within me than he that is in the world. Greater is he that is in me, amen, than he that is in the world. So what are we talking about tonight? We're talking about, amen, serving God. Hallelujah. We're talking about serving God, amen, like never before. We're talking about serving God, amen, with all our heart, amen, with all our mind, and with all our strength. Amen.
Power off.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. And so that's what we're talking about tonight. Amen. That's what we're talking about, is serving God with all of our heart. Amen. With all of our mind, with all of our soul, and with all of our strength. Amen. So that's what we're talking about tonight. Either we're going to serve God, bless the name of Jesus, or we're going to serve the devil. So let's look at either or. Either you're going to walk, amen, according to the flesh, or you're going to walk according to the spirit. Sin is anything that goes against God's will and his laws. To commit sin is to transgress or disobey these laws. The lust to sin dwells in human nature. In other words, it is contaminated and motivated by the sinful. Or you walk according to the spirit. Hallelujah. Those who live according to the flesh set their minds in things of the flesh. But those who live according to the spirit, the things of the spirit. For to be carnal minded, watch this, for to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritual minded is life and peace. Hallelujah. That's Romans 8, 5 and 6. Hallelujah. You can be in the flesh, Romans 7, 5, or you can be in the spirit, Romans 8 and 9, and it is up to you. And this is what we're talking about tonight. God is not going to make you serve him. God is simply give you his laws. He simply gives you what is required of you. And he says you'll be blessed. Amen. If you follow his laws, if you follow his precepts, amen, that you will be blessed going out and blessed coming in. And then he says, choose. Amen, this day whom you will serve. And so, on tonight, amen, you got to make a choice. You got to make a choice, all right? So, it's up to you. Are you in the spirit or are you in the flesh? And so, that's what you got to ask yourself tonight. Are you in the spirit, amen, or are you in the flesh? Do you operate more in the spirit, or do you operate more in the flesh? All right? And so we can tell, amen, if we're operating more in the flesh, why? Because we get a little upset a little bit more easier. If we were walking in the spirit, amen, the spirit of God will keep us, amen, at a level. It does not say that we're not going to get angry, but the Bible tells us that we will be angry and we would sin not. And so that's the difference in walking in the spirit and then walking in the flesh. And so it's not to say we're going to be walking around speaking in tongues all day, amen, carrying a Bible, reading our Bible openly all day. But he says he would keep you in perfect peace whose mind is steadfast on him. And so you may be working and going throughout your day, but yet your mind is being refreshed in the word as you think on the word, as you listen to the scriptures, or as you listen, amen, to the gospel songs, and not be caught up into foolishness. Now you're putting God in the head of your life, amen, and he can lead and he can guide you, all right? And so you're not walking according to the flesh. Now the enemy is going to bring things in your life throughout that day, amen, that's going to try
hallelujah, that he's going to try to frustrate your spirit, that he's going to try to get you angry. But people of God, I'm here to let you know tonight, amen, that God will bless you. God will bring you out, and he will bless your soul. Amen. So tonight, God will bless you. Amen. And God will bless, hallelujah, your soul tonight. All right. So either, watch this, we're going to be debtors to the flesh, or we're going to be debtors, amen, to the spirit. We are debtors, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. Romans 8 and 12, if you live in the spirit and walk, amen, in the spirit, the flesh, amen, walk in the spirit, the flesh with its lustful is powerless, amen, it is crucified. So if you are walking, amen, in the spirit, amen, you have crucified the flesh, you have crucified lust, you have, those things are not powerful in your life. The scripture also tells us that we are servants to whom our masters are. And so this brings us, amen, to the topic tonight, masters of the universe. So either the flesh is going to drive you, or either the spirit is going to drive you. And so the word of God tells us that we are servants to whom our masters are. In other words, if we allow sin, amen, to be controlled in our lives, we become servants of sin. In other words, our hands steal. Our feet take us in places that we should not go. Our mouth has filthy communication. Our eyes are looking at the wrong thing. Our ears, amen, are hearing the wrong things. And so we become servants to sin. But if we're walking in the spirit, amen, we become servants of righteousness. Our hands don't steal anymore, but our hands go together and clap and worship God. We lift our hands in the sanctuary and we worship the true and the living God. Our feet is not taking us to the club, but our feet is taking us to the house of God. We're hearing the word of God. And not only hearing the word of God, but we have become doers, amen, of his word. And so that moves us in the area of winning. That moves us in the area that we are winners. And so we're no more debtors to the flesh. Amen. But we become debtors to the spirit. So 2 Corinthians, watch this. Let's move from the area of defeat into winning. And so, watch this. It says, 2 Corinthians 13 and 5. It says, examine yourself. This is the hour, and this is the season that we have the time, amen, to examine ourselves. For the word of God tells us like this. Watch this. The word of God tells us, amen, to examine ourselves. Whether you be in the faith. One, that's what 2 Corinthians 13 and 5 says. Examine yourself whether, amen, ye be in the faith. Number two, prove your own selves. Know ye not your own selves, how that Jesus Christ is in you, except ye be reprobates. So, what is he talking about? He's talking about for every man to examine yourself to see whether you be in the faith. Every so often, you ought to examine yourself to see whether you are walking according to the word of God. All right? A self-examination is an excellent and an important duty for every Christian, and watch this, requires great diligence and faithfulness in its performance. Hallelujah. Amen. I can't get my headset to stay on right tonight. Amen. The devil don't want me to deliver this word, but amen. We're going to deliver this word tonight. Amen. Now, Self-examination is an excellent and important duty for every Christian and requires great diligence and faithfulness in its performance. It's necessary with regard to our comforts, great diligence, and duty because our heart is backwards. For if we apt to be deceived and willing to become deceived, many have been snared and perished by the negligence of duty. So if upon examination you find you are not diligent in God's service, then you are one of the dunamis. In other words, you are not where God wants you to be. And so in your self-examination tonight, amen, you have to find out whether you're in the faith, whether you're walking, amen, according to the word of God or you're not. When we render service to two masters, watch this. When you render service to two masters, the tendency is that you may develop more affinity for one than the other. If we share our service to God Almighty and the things of this world, we will miss the fellowship with God. This is where we are defeated at. We cannot afford, amen, to miss our fellowship, amen, with God. We cannot afford, amen, to miss our fellowship, amen, with God. And that's what happens when you render your service between two masters. Amen. Hallelujah. And because of serving two masters at the same time, you are seduced and have become weak spiritually. Thus, they cannot pray and are not committed to the things of God. When you find yourself, amen, not committed to the things of God as you should be, you got to ask yourself, what's getting my attention? What is getting my attention? Paul said, nothing shall separate me from the love of God. What shall separate me, rather, from the love of God? Shall tribulation, shall peril, shall nakedness, shall this separate me because I'm going through a pandemic? Should this separate me from the love of God? No. He says nothing. Nothing. We ought to not let nothing separate us from the love of God. All right? Nothing should separate us from the love of God. And so, let's look at Romans. Let's look at Romans 6 and 16. Know ye not that to whom ye yield your servants, yield yourself servants to obey, his servants ye are to whom ye obey. Whether sin unto death or of obedience unto righteousness. I'll read that one more time. Know ye not that to whom ye yield your servants to obey, his servants ye are to whom ye obey, whether of sin or obedience unto righteousness. Let's look at, amen, God's Word translation so we can break this down a little bit more. Hallelujah. It says, don't you know that if you offer to be someone's slave, you must obey that master. Oh, my God. Either your master of sin or your master is obedience. Letting sin be your master leads to death. Letting obedience be your master leads to God's approval. So Romans 6 and 16 simply says that whomever, hallelujah, you're slave to, amen, that is your master. And the slave can only obey its master. All right? And so we learn that down through history. But look at this. He says, whether it be that your sin is the slave or the obedience to God, Paul said it like this. Paul put it like this. He says, I am a prisoner. Amen. In other words, I yield myself to God. I'm following his ways. Amen. I'm following his precepts. And wherever he takes me, hallelujah, that's where I'm going. And you ought to say tonight, I'm going to be a winner because wherever he takes me, that's where I'm going. Hallelujah. Watch this. Every man is a servant of the master to whom he commands, he yields himself. Whether it be the sinful dispositions of his heart and actions which leads to death, or the new obeyed from the heart of the gospel, into which we are delivered as into a mold. And as the same metal becomes a new vessel, when melted and recast in another mold, so the believer becomes a new creature. And there are great differences in the liberty of the mind and spirit, and so opposite to the state of slavery. And so following God puts us in the liberty of mind and spirit, and it's opposite to the slavery of sin. All right? And so what is he simply talking about tonight? That when we follow God, God is going to bless our lives. He says, where the Spirit of the Lord is, amen, there is liberty. And so the liberty of the Spirit of God gives us, amen, to walk into the promises of God. No more are we defeated, amen. No more are we letting sin defeat us. But the Word of God tells us that the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So what are we talking about tonight? We're talking about masters of the universe. Are you master of your universe? In other words, are you master? Are you allowing God to lead and guide you that you can take control of the atmosphere around you, your circle, your domain, and that you can speak those things as though they were, that you can speak life into your situation? That's when you're moving from defeat, amen, to winning, that you can take the power of God that's in you and change your situation, amen, change your surrounding. And so that's what we're talking about tonight. God will allow you, amen, to become master of your universe. Notice what the Word of God said. I quoted it earlier. It says, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. And so it's telling me that I can speak those things in my life and turn my situation around. He tells me in Proverbs that life and death is in the power, amen, of my tongue. I can speak life into my situation when I allow God to be master of my universe. When I allow God, when I put him ahead of my life, hallelujah, I allow his spirit, amen, to lead and to guide me. Hallelujah. Watch this. To whom you yield yourself. To whom you yield yourself. To whom you yield. To whom you give up yourself to servitude. Hallelujah. Or obedience. The apostle here refers to voluntary servitude. But where this existed, the power of the master over, hallelujah, the time and services of the servant was absolute. The argument of the apostle is that Christians had become the voluntary servants of God and were therefore bound to obey him entirely. Servitude among the ancients, whether voluntary or involuntary, was rigid and gave the master an absolute right over his slave. Luke 17 and 9, John 8 and 34, John 15 and 15, to obey, to be obedient, or for the purpose of obeying his commandments. Watch this. To whom ye obey, to whom ye come under subjection. And that's the whole thing, people of God. When you become under the subjection of God's power, when you become under the subjection and allow God to rule your life, then and only then can you become the master of your universe. In other words, to him, God gives power. To them, he gave power, watch this, to become the sons of God. When you become a sons of God, you have rights, amen, that an outsider don't have rights to. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. I'll say that one more time. When you become a son of God, you have rights to the kingdom of God that an outsider don't have rights to. Can I break it down to you in the natural? If you are a son, or if you are a daughter and you have a physical father, or you have a physical mother, or you have both in the household, the son and the daughter has rights to everything inside of the house. Amen. They have rights to the refrigerator. They have rights to the food. They have rights to the running water. They have rights to the lights. They have rights to the beds. Amen. They have rights to everything in that house because they're a son, because they're a daughter. Now, those that come to the house, amen, they may be relatives, but they can't go in the refrigerator. They don't have the right to. They're not a son. They're not a daughter. The thief don't have rights to enter your house except you invite him in. Well, I'll say that one more time. A thief does not have rights to your house unless he breaks in or you invite him or her in. Now, watch this. They don't have the right to be in the house. And so whatever they take out the house, they're taking it illegally. We got some illegal Christians out here. We got some illegal people in the body of Christ, amen, that's claiming to be children of God that are taking things that don't belong to them. But I'm here to let you know tonight, in the kingdom of God, he says to them, I give you power, amen, to become the sons of God. Why? Because you put me first in your life. I'm taking over your life. I'm leading you, guiding you. Now you become a son. Now you have access to healing. Now you have access, amen, to healing. Now the sinner man has access to healing, but it is not in abundance. But you have access to healing in abundance because you are a son and you are a daughter of God. So I'm here to let you know tonight, to whom you obey, to whom you become the subjection to, you are bound to obey his requirements. So we are bound to obey what God has called us to be. We are bound to obey the words of God. When you obey the words of God, it opens avenues and doors. Hallelujah. It says, eyes have not seen, nor ears have heard the thing that God has prepared for them that love him. Listen, You don't know what God has in store for you just for obeying his word, but just for following his commandment. He says, eyes haven't even seen, nor ears even heard. That means there is something in store for you that is so great by following God. Hallelujah. And so when you yield yourself to God, and overall, you become winners. Come on, come on. I'm a winner. Type tonight. I am, amen, a winner. I am winning. Come on. Type tonight. I am winning. No more are we going to be defeated. Amen. But we're going to win. We're going to win tonight. We're going to win. We're going to get everything, amen, God has in store for us. Every blessing he has promised, you're going to get it tonight. Everything that he has in store for you, amen, you're going to set yourself, amen, in position. When you're a son, a hallelujah, spiritual son, spiritual daughter in Christ, amen, you're setting yourself, amen, in position to get what God has in store for you. So, in essence, you have become master, amen, of your universe. You have set your priorities, amen, in order, and you're following the will of God, and no more you're going to let distractions, no more you're going to allow the enemy to rob you. God is going to restore what the cankerworm have ate him. God is going to restore what the palmer worm have ate him. God is going to set you back in the rightful place, amen, just like, amen, hallelujah, just like the son, hallelujah, the prodigal son that left home and he wanted his goods before time and he went out into the world. We know the story, amen, that he went out into the world, amen, and he spent all his goods. He spent all that he had. The enemy robbed him, hallelujah, and took away everything that he had. And so he made up in his mind, I'm going to go back, amen, to my father's house. For my father got cattle on 1,000 hills. My father got places. My father got servants upon servants. I'm here to let you know the blessings of God is just at the tip of the iceberg. The blessings of God is just right in your reach. All you have to do is move out the area of defeat and move into the area of winning. Hallelujah. The blessings of God is here for you. The word of God will give you power. The word of God will give you strength like never before. It is out of your obedience, amen, that you get your blessing. It is out of your obedience that you receive joy in the hour that you don't have joy. It is out of your obedience to the servitude of God that God will strengthen you in the time that you need strength. I feel him known tonight. Listen, this is the hour and this is the season, people of God, that you, it's time for you, amen, to move to winning. It is time for you that you get your miracle. Ask yourself the question tonight. How long are you going to be without your miracle? How long will the enemy continue to rob you? How long will the enemy continue to set you in the corner and you don't get your blessing? How long will you allow the enemy, amen, to keep your family bound? How long will you allow the enemy to keep, hallelujah, your daughter bound? How long will you allow the enemy to keep your son bound? How long will you allow the enemy to keep you bound? You ought to type on the screen tonight that it's time for me to win. I'm going to set my pride straight. I'm going to serve God. When the church doors open, I'm going to run between the porch and the altar, and I'm going to cry out to God like never before. I'm going to lift my hands in the sanctuary. I'm going to give him praise. I'm going to give him glory. I'm going to give him honor. Why? Because it's time to win. We've been losing long enough, people of God. You've been allowing the enemy to take your blessing long enough. You've been allowing the enemy to take your peace of mind long enough. You've been allowing the enemy to put you in the depression long enough. Now is the time for you to stand up against the enemy. The Bible says, amen, the kingdom suffered violence, but the violent take it by force. How many violent people out there in the spirit? How many violent people that don't take back what the devil stole? You ought to clap your hands wherever you are and tell the enemy, I'm going to take back what the enemy stole from me. I'm going to take back what the enemy stole from me. And that's what we're talking about, becoming masters of your universe. You're not going to allow the enemy to no longer rob you. Hallelujah. You're not going to allow the enemy, amen, to keep keeping you bound. You're not going to allow the enemy, hallelujah, to keep you bound. Paul devoted himself completely to the Lord Jesus Christ, and he submitted himself entirely to his divine will. Hallelujah. Listen to this. Just as Paul was the example, amen, committed himself totally, submitted himself totally to the divine will of God, it set Paul in a place above no other. Tonight, God want to set you in a place above your enemies. God want to set you a place above people that's talking about you. God want to put you and set you to the table when you get your blessing, set you to the table. He says, I prepare a table, amen, in the presence of my enemy. God will put a table in the presence of your enemies when you commit yourself to the divine will of God. Paul's will has been given up to the sovereign lordship of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. You got to give up your will. That's what's keeping us bound. That's what's keeping us defeated. Amen. That we won't give up our will. You got to give up your will. Even Jesus, oh my Lord, even Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane, his flesh had to give up to the will of the Spirit. It was the divine will of God that Jesus died on the cross for our sins. But his flesh began to cry out and say, Father, if it's possible, let this cup pass from me. I know people are saying tonight, if it's possible, God, let this cup of this pandemic pass from us. But I'm here to let you know tonight, some things, amen, we just got to go through because it's the will of God. Some things we just have got to go through. I preached a message one time, amen, accept what God allows. Now we're going back to Garden of Gethsemane, and Jesus began to pray, Lord, nevertheless, God, if it's possible, hallelujah, let this cup pass from me, right? Now, but that was his flesh, but his spirit, the will of the spirit, begin to kick in and say, nevertheless, not my will, but thine will be done. And so that's what we're talking about. You have to get in the mold. You have to get in the mold of saying, Lord, nevertheless, not my will, but thine will be done. Now, we have to be careful. What is the will of God? And so, but I'm here to let you know tonight that God will give you strength to carry out his will. God will give you strength even in the time of distress, even Jesus was on the cross and he began to cry out, Abba, Abba, Father, why hast thou forsaken me? But I'm here to let you know tonight that God has not forsaken you. Even in this pandemic, God has not forsaken you. Even in your hour of distress, God has not forsaken you. I know it feels lonely sometimes. Amen. Following the will of God. I'm talking to somebody tonight. I know it feels lonely. It feels like you're all by yourself. Amen. Following the will of God. And you got nobody to lean on. And you got nobody to trust. But I heard the voice of the Lord say, though you walk through the valley in the shadow of death, I am with you. I am the Lord thy God. And I change not. People of God, I'm letting you know tonight that the Lord is with us. He has not forsaken us. He has not forsaken us. Oh, he's looking for us to totally surrender. He's looking for us to totally surrender. And so in my closing tonight, are you the master of your universe? Are you the master of your situations, or how are you allowing your situations and your trial to control you? We can see it all throughout the land, people of God, that the pandemic is controlling some people. People are treating one another with no kindness. People are treating one another with no love. We got police officers just recently shooting a man in the back 8 times, and this man is paralyzed from the waist down. We have people that the pandemic, it has set people on edge, and they're like ticking time bombs, and they're ready to go off. But God said, I will keep you in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed fast on him. And so God has not forsaken us. And God is looking for somebody to trust him. God is looking for somebody to stand up and take control of your situation. Not let your situation take control of you. You cannot serve God and mammon too. In other words, the word mammon means wealth. You cannot allow wealth. Amen. We have allowed wealth. Some of us, we have allowed wealth, amen, to take over our life. But I heard a saying that goes like this. And it says, I'm going to make the money, but I'm not going to let the money make me. You cannot allow the enemy to allow the money to make you and turn you into something that you're not. So you have to become master, amen, of your universe. You have to become master. Amen. God has made us the head, amen, and not the tail. And so on tonight, I want you tonight to hear me. Become masters of your universe. Amen. Become what God has, amen, called you to be. Hallelujah. Amen. Become what God has called you to be. It's time. It's time to win. It's time to win. People of God, it's time to win. Hallelujah. It's time to win. And so tonight, as we go out, we're going to pray that you become winners on tonight. We're going to pray that the blessings of God, amen, overtake your home. We're going to pray that the peace of God that surpasses all your understanding will guide your heart and will guide your mind tonight. Hallelujah. On tonight, amen. We don't have our closing music tonight, but I want you to say, I am a winner, and I'm going to get the miracles, amen, that God has for me. I'm going to get everything that he has for me. The songwriter says, amen, what God has for me, hallelujah, it is for me. Hallelujah. And so tonight, you must be the master of your universe. You have to be the master of your universe. So we thank you on tonight. Amen. For joining us. Amen. Next week, if the Lord say the same, amen, we're going to move into session 6. And it's what winning looks like. We're going to show you. Don't miss this on next week. We're going to talk about, amen, what winning looks like. And I'm going to give you an illustration on next week. You're going to love this illustration on next week, what winning looks like. Some of us don't know what winning looks like. Some of us don't know how to move in the season of winning. Amen. And we're stuck in the season of defeat. But we're going to show you on tomorrow, on next week, amen, session 6, what winning looks like. Don't miss. Hallelujah. Don't miss what God has in store for you. Amen. Next week. All right, we're going to say a word of prayer, and we're going to let you go. Father, in the precious name of Jesus, we ask God that you continue to bless your people. We ask God that you continue to have your way in their life. Hallelujah. We ask God that you continue to move in their life like never before. We ask God that your blessings overshadow and overtake them. God, wherever their feet go, God, that they will be blessed, and their children will call them blessed, and God, the enemy will call them blessed in the precious name of Jesus. And God, move in their life, even in this pandemic. Have your way, and God, let your will be done in the precious name of Jesus. In the precious name of Jesus. And we count it done. We count it done. People of God, thank you for joining us on tonight. Thank you. Amen, for joining us on tonight. And I'm here to let you know that God still saves. Amen. And God still set free. And he still delivers. Amen. He still delivers. Amen. He still delivers. And he still set free. Hallelujah. And so tonight, amen. Tonight, we are winners on tonight. And I want you, people of God, to continue, amen, to watch us right here on YouTube. Amen. Watch us as God continues to bless our life, as he continues to bless your life. Amen. Watch us on YouTube. Watch us on Facebook. Amen. Go to our YouTube channel. Amen. LOTWC Space Church. Amen. Hallelujah. On our YouTube channel. Amen. LOTWCINC. Amen. Our YouTube channel, and subscribe. Continue to watch us here live on Facebook. We'll be back with you Sunday morning at 11 a.m. where God will be moving by his spirit and God will be moving by his power. Amen. Listen to us on WTAN. Amen. WTAN 1340 on your AM dial right here in Tampa, Florida. Amen. This week is going to be a week of miracles. You got to look for it. And you got to believe it. Amen. You got to believe it and you got to receive it. Amen. Hallelujah. And so we want to also on tonight, amen, we want to give you our prayer line. We want to give you our prayer line. Tune in, amen, on our prayer line. Hallelujah. Tune in on our prayer line. Amen. Mondays, Thursdays, and Fridays at 727. 727, we want you to call this number of the prayer line. Put your prayer request in as we pray for God to move in your life. Amen. The prayer line is area code 951-981. Hallelujah. 7249. Again, that prayer line is, hallelujah, that prayer line is, hallelujah, 951-981-7249. Call that number on tomorrow night, amen, at 727, and watch God move in your life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to bless the Lord as we listen on this great song. Your miracle, hallelujah, is on the way. Your miracle, amen, is on the way. Hallelujah. And so tonight, people of God, we thank you once again, hallelujah, for joining us right here. Amen. We thank you for joining us. Amen, right here at Light of the World Church. Amen, a church where everybody is somebody. Amen, and Christ is all. Amen. So we praise God. Amen for you joining us. We praise God for God moving in your life. Amen. Continue to watch us. Continue, amen, to, amen, look at us here alive. Amen. Don't forget. Amen. You can sow your seeds tonight. Amen. You can sow your seeds tonight. Hallelujah. Cash App, $ Light, LIGHT 471-4701. Amen. www.paypal. Amen. .me/ LOTWC Church. Amen. Also on our online giving, Tithely, TITHE.LY. Amen. And if you don't have the technology, you can always give, amen, via by U.S. Postal Service, amen, to Light of the World, amen, 4701 North 15th Street, Tampa, Florida, 33610, and to our P.O. Box, 75782, Tampa, Florida, 33675. Amen. So, again, God bless you. May heaven continue to smile upon you. We hope we said something tonight that's going to push you into your destiny. We hope we said something tonight that's going to push you, amen, to your next level. May God bless you and heaven continuously smile upon you. This is Pastor Tim Brown, and we're looking forward, amen, to seeing you, amen, next week. God bless you.